I'm really sorry, guys. I don't know what has happened today. Getting me disconnected. Okay. Right here. One last cell that we need to learn is aqueous H2SO4. With platinum electrode. Okay, now from H2SO4 we are going to get 2H+ ions and SO4 2-. From water molecule, I am going to get 1H+ and 1OH-. Now, in cathode, there is only one reaction that is possible. Since we have only one cation, that is H+. Whether we take the H2SO4H+ or we take the water H+, we are going to have only H. Salman, at what? कहाँ तक आप लोगों ने सुना था? Till cathode, you was it connected till cathode?
No, you didn't write cathode. You just wrote like cathode, and then you got disconnected.
Just cathode. Okay. So I was saying that when we are having in cathode, we have only one cation, that is H+, right? So there is no other cation. That is why only one reaction is possible. That is the reaction of H+. That means the reduction of H+ is possible at cathode. No other cation is there. That is why there is no other option. But when we are having anode reaction, in that oxidation of either OH- can take place or SO4 2- can take place depending on the concentration of the solution. If the solution is dilute, that means we have less H2SO4. That means OH- will be predominant and it will be giving you this reaction, giving you the O2 gas. But if it is concentrated, then in that case, what is going to happen? You are going to have reaction in which SO4 2-, it is going to get oxidized to S2O8 2- plus 2 electron. Now, further this, it reacts and it forms H2S2O8. This is per oxo disulfuric acid. Done, guys. Is one of these on me?
So 1 minute.
1 minute, okay.
Okay, let's scroll up.
Done? Done or scroll up? What did you say?
Scroll up.
Just a scroll. Yeah, okay. I hope everyone is done. And then you are going to write quantitative analysis of electrolysis. Right here, number one, Faraday's law of electrolysis. So all the quantitative analysis, it was done by Faraday, and he gave mainly one law is the main law. Second law, it is again, you can derive the second law from the first law itself, and all the numericals can be done on the basis of first law itself. Okay. So main focus we have to put in the first law. Please write Faraday's law. Of electrolysis. Right, the first law of electrolysis. Okay, so this first law is quite straightforward. It says that the mass of chemical substance that is going to be deposited, that means if you are having metal, that metal is going to be deposited in either cathode, or that metal is going to be deposited in the cathode, or whatever gas is being liberated. So whatever product you are going to get formed, it is going to be directly proportional to on the electricity that you are putting it. If you are putting in more electricity, that means more product will be formed. Okay, so that first law is very straightforward. It tells that the mass of chemical substance The mass of chemical substance deposited or liberated at an electrode is directly proportional to the current passed and time. It is saying the mass is directly proportional to the current, and the mass deposited is directly proportional to the time also. That means mass is directly proportional to I into T, and if I write a proportionality constant, it will give me some z. It is the proportionality constant I times t. Okay, and you should also remember one thing: current is equal to charge per unit time, the charge passed per unit time. So I can say that I t is equal to q, and hence I can write mass is equal to z times q. Okay, and Z is known as electrochemical equivalent. Now, what is electrochemical equivalent? See, if you want to define any... Let me know once you're done.
Done, sir.
Done. So whenever we need to, whenever we want to define a constant, what do? Now the constant will be either in the left hand side or the right hand side of the equation. So now the constant here, it is in what? The right hand side of the equation. And you are going to have a variable in the right hand side. What we need to do, we need to convert that variable into one and then define the constant. So Z is what? It is electrochemical equivalent. And if I do the Q is equal to one, that means charge is equal to one, then whatever mass is deposited, it is equivalent to the electrochemical equivalent. Please write electrochemical equivalent. Electrochemical equivalent is defined as is the mass deposited or liberated when 1 coulomb of charge is passed through electrolyte. Let me know once you're done. Done, guys. Yes or no, please tell me.
Done, sir.
Okay. What is M is equal to? We saw that Z into Q. Okay. When Q is equal to 1 coulomb, the mass deposited will be equal to electrochemical equivalent. That was the meaning of the definition. Now, just tell me one thing. If I have 2H plus, okay, I have 2H plus ion. And I want to convert it to H2 gas. How much electron will be needed for this? Tell me, guys. How many electrons will be needed for this?
Two electrons.
If I have Na plus and I want to convert it to sodium solid, then how many electrons?
One electron.
If I have Al3 plus to aluminium, how many electrons?
3 electrons.
Similarly, if I have I negative to I2. So it is going to give electrons now. So how much electron, how many electrons it is going to give me now?
2 electrons.
What about others? Or kisi ko nahi aa raha hai? Haan, tell me guys. Yes, Minashi, Khalid, Salman, Saif. You understood these things? Yes or no, please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, na? Theek hai. So now, when we say 2 electrons and when we say 1 electron or 3 electrons or when we say 2 H plus, that does not mean we have only 2 H plus. This 2, it means what? This 2 means? This 2 will mean 2 moles, right? So this 2 will also mean 2 mole of electron will be needed if we have 2 H plus ion. Similar, that means also we can say, if I have 2 electron, this is equal to 2 Faraday of charge. That means 2 mole of electron will have 2 Faraday of charge. I hope all of these things you know, guys, right? If I have 1 mole of electron, it is equal to 1 Faraday. Yaad hai na aap logo ko? When we were doing the electrochemical cell, in that we electrochemical cell and Gibbs free energy. In that case, we discussed this Faraday. What is 1 Faraday? 1 Faraday is the charge on 1 mole of electrons. Okay. So right here, calculate the charge required for following. Number one, I want to get 2 mole of I2 from potassium iodide. Okay, from potassium iodide. Now, the first thing first, what you have to determine here, you have to first of all determine what is the number of moles that you require. I require 2 moles. Okay, first thing what you will determine, how many moles you require. You require how many moles? 2 moles. If they are giving you, for example, they said that you need 100 grams of I2 from Ki. So first thing you will say is that how many moles is required? Okay, you have to calculate what? The number of moles required. So you need how many moles? You need 2 moles. Then you will tell me what is the delta OS, change in oxidation state. Of what? Here we require iodine. So we are going to check the delta OS, change in oxidation state of iodine. So in Ki, iodine is in the form of I negative. And from iodine, I need to get I2, right? From iodine, I need to get what? From iodine, I need to get I2. Now for here, if I need 1 I2, I need to have this. And what is the number of electron? What is the change in oxidation state?
2 electrons.
Tell me again. How many electrons is needed? 2 electrons, right? 2 electrons. So change in oxidation state or the number of moles that is required, that is equal to what? 2. And hence, charge required will be equal to 2 into 2, that is equal to 4 Faraday. Okay. So you are going to need number of moles and change in oxidation state. That's it. Okay, there is another way of doing this. I mean, you can use any one of the ways. It is almost similar. If I need 2 moles of I2, So I will write like this, 2 moles of I2. For 2 moles of I2, I need 4 moles of I negative. All of you understood this? Yes or no? Please tell me how to write this type of statements. I need what? First of all, you will write, what do you need? You need 2 moles of I2. So for 2 moles of I2, you need what? 4 iodine. 4 iodine, and iodine is in the form of iodine negative, that is iodide ion, right? Now from here, you can see that the number of moles of ions you need. What is the number of moles of ion I need? I need 4 moles of ion. And now you can just write the change in oxidation state. So from -1 to 0, what is the change in oxidation state? It is 1. 4 into 1, it is equal to 4 Faraday. Okay, you can use any one of the forms. The first one or the second one. Aage badhein, yes or no, please tell me. I would suggest that this form will be a bit more useful. So maybe learn this form also. Can I move on? Yes or no, please tell me, guys. Aake padhein. Aastha, Khalid, Khalil, Minashi, tell me.
Yes, sir.
Achha. Right, next. 3 moles of Cl2. From calcium chloride. Okay, so what do I need? I need 3 moles of Cl2. So how many chlorines do I need? Tell me, guys. How many chlorines?
6.
Very good. So 6 chlorines. And what is the charge on chlorine? It is chloride ion. That means Cl negative. Now here it is in -1. Here it is in 0. So what will be the charge required? Q will be equal to, what is the number of moles? Number of moles is equal to 6. The 6 here multiplied by 1, that is equal to 6 Faraday. Two mole of copper from copper 2+. Okay, 2 moles of copper from copper 2+. So I need what? 2 moles of copper. For 2 moles of copper, I need 2 moles of copper 2+. And how many electrons will be needed here? What is it? No, you just need to write. Number of moles is equal to 2 mole. And what is the delta OS? What is the delta OS, guys? Change in oxidation state is +2, and here it is 0. So what is the change? This is the change of 2. So charge will be equal to 2 into 2, that is equal to 4 Faraday. Right, next. 2 mole of MnO4 negative to Mn2+. Now for this, you need to write the reaction. What is the reaction we need? The reaction is MnO4 negative to Mn2+. So how many moles of MnO4 negative? 2 moles of MnO4 negative. Okay. So 2 moles of MnO4 negative. So I will get 2 moles of Mn2 plus also. So from here, we can easily see N is equal to 2 moles. Now the thing is, what is delta OS? Now delta OS, you can calculate here. Oxygen has how much? Oxygen has minus 2. Minus 2 times 4 will be equal to minus 8. Okay. When minus 8 will go to the right hand side, it will become what? Plus 8. And there is a minus sign here. So it will become plus 7. Jin logo samajh nahi aaya, please see here. X plus 2 into minus, sorry, 4 into minus 2 is equal to minus 1. Now X will be equal to minus 1 plus 8. X will be equal to plus 7. So here the oxidation state of Mn is plus 7. Here the oxidation state of Mn is what? Plus 2. What is the change? 5. So Q will be equal to N into delta OS, that is equal to 10 Faraday. Right, the fifth one. Three moles of FeO. 2 Fe2O3. Again, so start with 3 moles of FeO. 2 Fe2O3. Number of moles is equal to 3. Okay. Now we just need to calculate what is the oxidation state of Fe. See, here it is plus 2, and here it is what? Plus 3. So what is the change in oxidation state? It is equal to 1. So Q will be equal to 3 into 1, that is equal to 3 Faraday. Can you write the last one? Aluminium. Is anyone saying something? 54 grams of aluminium from Al2O3. First thing is that you need to calculate the number of moles of aluminium needed. Okay, so number of moles, first of all, calculate and do the reaction. From now, we are going from Al2O3 and we are getting aluminium. Okay, get the oxidation state of Al in aluminium. Get the oxidation state of Al in Al2O3 and the oxidation state of Al in Al. The steps are easy.
So is it 5 Hg?
5 Hg. 5 Hg नहीं है वो, 54 ग्राम है.
Okay.
So first of all, you have to convert that grams to number of moles. Okay. You need the molar mass of aluminium. You guys know the molar mass of aluminium? No. Does anyone know that? It is 27 grams per mole. If you are getting stuck, please let me know. No one is done. Number of moles to bata diye kitna aaya, 54 grams of aluminium. What will be the number of moles? Yeah, that's correct. Ab Al2O3 mein aluminium ka kya hai oxidation state? Yeah, I think that is correct. Now see, Al2O3, I can take 2x for aluminium because there are two aluminiums, plus 3 into minus 2 is equal to 0 because there is no charge on the Al2O3 molecule. And then I'm going to write what? 2x, it is equal to plus 6. X will be equal to plus 3. And we are going from Al plus 3 to aluminium. So the change in oxidation state is equal to what? Delta OS is equal to plus 3. Or rather, we can just write 3. And hence, the Q will be equal to 3 times 2. That is equal to 6 Faraday. 20 grams of calcium from calcium chloride. What is the molar mass of calcium? Tell me, guys. I have yaad kar ke sab 40 grams per mole. Astha and Saif has given me the answer. Yeah, that is correct. Yes, Meenakshi, correct. Khalid, Salman, guys, can the answer? Oh, okay, Rupesh Salman.
Like I have a head pain and coughing. Yeah.
Sure. Are you taking medicine?
Yeah, weather is changing, so.
Oh. Now you'll write a question which has been asked for 5 marks. What about Khalid, Umar? You guys have not given the answer. Khalil also, I think. Khalil also did not give me any answer, no? Huh? These are easy questions. Those are tough, nahi hai. Those who have given the answer, please write this next question. देखिए सिर्फ सवाल बड़ा है ठीक है, अदरवाइज द आंसर इज स्मॉल, नॉट वेरी टफ ऑल्सो. देर आर टू फॉर्मुलाज दैट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर, ओनली टू फॉर्मुलाज फॉर ऑल ऑफ दीज टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन. द चार्ज इट इज इक्वल टू, चार्ज इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ मोल्स टाइम्स चेंज इन ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट. ओके, देन दिस चार्ज विल बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हाट इट, दिस विल बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ फैराडे. कन्वर्ट दिस टू कूलम्ब्स, हाउ विल यू कन्वर्ट दिस टू कूलम्ब? 96500 कूलम्ब इज इक्वल टू 1 फैराडे. ओके, वंस यू कन्वर्ट दिस फैराडेज इन टू कूलम्ब, फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू गॉट 2 फैराडे, 3 फैराडे, वॉट एवर फैराडे यू गेट, यू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल चेंज इट टू कूलम्ब. ओके, एंड देन वॉट यू आर गोइंग टू डू, यू आर गोइंग टू रिमेंबर दिस फॉर्मुला, दैट इज Q is equal to IT. Okay. Q is equal to what? Q is equal to IT. Okay. And from here, you know the Q in terms of coulomb. This should be in coulomb. This I will be in terms of ampere. And this time should be in terms of seconds. Okay. This will be in terms of seconds. So from here, you can get time is equal to Q upon I. Okay. So you have been given what? You have been given a steady current of 1.5 ampere is passed through them. That means all of these particular cells, they have 1.5 ampere current is passing through all of them. Until 1.45 grams of silver, until 1.45 grams of silver is deposited on the cathode. Okay, it is deposited on the cathode. So from 1.45 grams, you are going to convert that to number of moles. Okay, once you convert that to number of moles, you will see what is this silver nitrate. Okay, see this, it is silver nitrate. So I am going from Ag NO3 to Ag. So what is the change in oxidation state? You can get this from the reaction. You will get the charge in terms of coulomb, sorry, in terms of Faraday. And then you are going to convert it in terms of coulomb. Once you get in terms of coulomb, you already have the charge that you calculated just now. You have the current in terms of ampere, 1.5 ampere. You are going to get the time for this. Okay, you are going to get the time for this. So please calculate first of all what is the Q by multiplying number of moles into delta OS. Astha, Minashi, Saf, you guys understood what how to do this 97th question? Yes or no, please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Anna, take it. Start please. what happened? Alpha Cf. So you don't get anything. Sorry?
No, sir, I did, but then I forgot to convert it into coulombs. So like that.
Oh, okay, okay. Cf, yeah, I think that is correct, sir. Yes, that is correct. Okay. So that is the time. Okay. That is the time. Okay. You just keep that time there. Then how, what mass of copper and what mass of zinc are deposited on the concerned electrodes? You have to calculate that. In order to calculate that mass, what we need to do is, please see. Okay. Calm KG. Keep it till here. We'll discuss this part later on. Okay. What mass of copper and what mass of zinc is deposited. It is very similar, but we will discuss it in the next class. Okay. And others who did not do this question, please try this at home. Okay. What is the method? Whatever the method is being used, I have already provided that. Maybe. Khalil. Okay. I need to convert that to minute. I remember the answer in minutes. So wait a second, Asta.